Hello everyone, welcome to the class. So in this video I am going to explain you about the sulfur halides and its synthetic applications. So this video is the continuation of previous video where we have discussed about the applications of sulfur halides, especially the reaction called Johnson-Cory-Chekhovsky reaction, which mainly useful for the synthesis of epoxides, aziridines and cyclopropane derivatives from the reaction of sulfur halides with carbonyl compounds, imines and alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds respectively. And we have also discussed some examples to synthesize different kind of heterocyclic compounds using sulfur halides. So in this video let us discuss another application, that is reaction of halide with the cyclic ketones. See, consider this example where the reaction of this cyclohexanone treating with the dimethyl sulfonium methylide, which produces oxirane or epoxide as the product, which is well known. But if you observe carefully, in this reaction the CC bond formed here, that means this reaction generally useful for the insertion of CH2 in this. So the CC bond formation takes place here, and the CC bond in this epoxide is at axial position. Why this is coming in axial position? Let us consider mechanism. As we know, the initial step in this reaction is the addition, that means addition of nucleophile in this halide towards the electrophilic carbon in the carbonyl compounds, which gives you a deuter ion. So this deuter ion, in this deuter ion the oxy anion, which acts as a nucleophile, that means intramolecular nucleophile, it attacks at the electrophilic carbon which bears a good leaving group, that is dimethyl sulfonium. See, in the first step halide acts as nucleophile and carbonyl carbon acts as electrophile. Once you get this deuter ion, the oxy anion acts as nucleophile and this electrophile is acting, oxy anion acting as nucleophile and this carbon acting as electrophile. Once this oxy anion attack onto this electrophile, by the loss of dimethyl sulfide, which produces this epoxide product majorly, that is the reason you are getting here CC bond in axial position. Consider another example where the reaction of cyclohexanone with dimethyl oxosulfonium methylide, which produces the same epoxide product, but the thing is the CC bond present in this epoxide is at equatorial position, if you observe carefully. So consider the mechanism to get this CC bond at equatorial position is, see, this cyclohexanone has an electrophilic carbon center and halide carbon which bears a negative charge acts as a nucleophile. The initial step is the nucleophilic addition onto this electrophilic carbon, which gives a deuter ion, followed by the formed oxygen anion acts as an intramolecular nucleophile and attacks onto this electrophilic carbon which bears a good leaving group, dimethyl oxosulfonium ion. So by the loss of DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxide, which gives you the required epoxide, where this epoxide has CC bond at equatorial position. In the conclusion, this reaction of halides with cyclic ketones, they produce epoxides as the main products, but only thing is the attacking of this halides are important. In the case of dimethyl sulfonium methylide, the attack takes place from axial position, whereas in the case of dimethyl sulfoxonium methylide, it takes place at equatorial position. The reason may be the presence of 1,3-diazole interactions leads to the attacking of this dimethyl sulfoxonium halide from equatorial position, that leads to the epoxide which contains a CC bond at equatorial position. So this is the application where you can synthesize epoxides from cyclic ketones with the halides. Consider other application, that is the reaction of halides with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. Let us consider two cases, that is dimethyl sulfonium methylate. When you treat with alpha beta unsaturated compounds, generally it produces epoxides as main products, whereas the dimethyl oxosulfonium methylate with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, generally it leads to the cyclopropyl derivatives or cyclopropane derivatives. Let us consider each case. Let us consider the reaction between this dimethyl sulfonium halide with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, which gives epoxides as main products. Consider the first case where the sulfonium halides with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. See, you have dimethyl sulfonium halide where this carbon has a group or atom. Suppose if the group is H, sorry, if the R is H, okay, so it is just simple dimethyl sulfonium methylate. If suppose this group has electron withdrawing group, so you have two different type of substrates or two different type of halides you have here. Once you treat this with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, which gives you here two different type of products. One is epoxide and another one is cyclopropane derivative. So when this R is H, that means it is simple dimethyl sulfonium methylate, it gives you epoxide majorly. When R is having electron withdrawing group, it gives you cyclopropanation product majorly. So what kind of mechanism involved in this? Consider the first halide, that is dimethyl sulfonium methylide when you treat with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, this reaction prefers 1-2 addition, and this reaction is very fast and it is irreversible, because this R is H, so it is unstable and reactive halide. So this unstable or reactive halide, when you treat with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, this reaction undergo irreversible attack by this nucleophile, which gives you a jitter ion intermediate. Once you get this jitter intermediate, this oxygen nucleophile attack at this electrophilic carbon, so the loss of dimethyl sulfide gives you epoxide majorly. Consider other case where the halide carbonium carbon, which is having electron withdrawing group, which is a stable halide, which considers stable halide, when you treat with this, allied with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. In this case, here 1-2 addition is fast, but it is reversible because of the stable allied intermediate. We have already discussed about the reversibility, degree of reversibility of this reaction. If suppose your starting material allied is stable, then the equilibration shifts towards the allied formation majorly. So that is the reason when you take this stable allied, okay, this reaction will prefer 1-2 addition, but it is reversible. So first, once it undergo 1-2 addition, you will get a deuterion. As we know here, this reaction is reversible. So what happens again? The formation of allyl takes place, which gives back the same alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound followed by sulfonium allyl. Now what happens? This allyl preferably attack 1-4 addition, which is slow step, whereas in the case of 1-2 addition it is fast. So it is reversible though. So you are getting your alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound and your allyl back. So now this allyl attack at this 1-4 addition, which results a deuterion. Followed by cyclopropanation. Leads to the cyclopropyl derivative. So, in both cases, if you compare both cases, what happens? If you take a unstable and reactive sulfonium allyl, treat with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, you will get epoxide majorly. Whereas if you take a stable sulfonium allyl, that means this carbanion has electron with the ring group. So when you treat this stable allyl with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, generally it prefers 1-2 addition, which is slow step, and gives you cyclopropane derivative majorly. So in the case of sulfonium allylates, depends on the substituents present on the carbanion, it gives you different kind of products. Come to the other case where the reaction of dimethyl sulfoxonium methylide, when you treat with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, which also results the cyclopropane derivative majorly. Cyclopropane derivative or cyclopropyl derivative majorly. So the mechanism is, so this alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound has two different type of electrophilic carbons, where this is hard electrophile, because this carbon directly attached to oxygen, that means which is electronegative atom, and there is another carbon which is soft electrophile. So this is called soft electrophile, this is called hard electrophile. So now your allyl, that means dimethyl sulfoxonium allyl, initiate the reaction by nucleophilic addition. So the nucleophilic addition takes place at this soft electrophile. That means this reaction prefers 1-4 addition. 1-4 addition, which results a deuterion. Next. the nucleophile attack onto this electrophilic carbon, which results a cyclopropane derivative. So this is all about the reaction of halides with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. See, if you consider, in conclusion, if you consider sulfonium salts, this is depends on the R. If suppose R is H, when you treat with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, it results epoxide majorly. If suppose R is electron withdrawing group, it results cyclopropane or propyl derivatives majorly. Whereas the treatment of dimethyl sulfoxonium halide with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds generally gives you cyclopropyl derivatives majorly. So this is all about the conclusion of reaction of halides with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. Let us take an example where the treatment of cyclohexenone with the two different type of halides, that is dimethyl sulfonium methylate and dimethyl sulfoxonium methylate, which produces three different type of products. In the first case, the treatment of this alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, which gives you epoxide product majorly, whereas the treatment of this dimethyl sulfoxonium methylate with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, which gives you 1,4 addition product, that means cyclopropanation. So in the both cases, you are observing epoxide formation and cyclopropanation. Okay, this is all about the reaction of alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds with the halides, sulfur halides. So when you treat this alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound with the dimethyl sulfoxonium methylate, you are ending up with a cyclopropyl derivative. So with the help of this dimethyl sulfoxonium methylate, you can only prepare the cyclopropane, okay, which is unsubstituted. So if you want to prepare this substituted cyclopropane derivatives, you can use another reagent that is called dialkyl amino oxo sulfonium alkylide. Okay, so instead of using this dimethyl oxo sulfonium methylate, you can replace this with the dialkyl amino oxo sulfonium alkylate, where this carbene anion has different substituents. So earlier in this case you have only methylate, so in this case you have substituents. So when you treat this reagent sulfur halide with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, generally this reaction produces a cyclopropane derivative. So to achieve the formation of cyclopropane derivatives, instead of using this Corey-Chekhovsky reagent, that is dimethyl sulfoxonium methylate, you can use this dialkyl amino oxo sulfonium alkylate, which is very helpful to give you or produce the derivatives, substituted cyclopropane derivatives. The other application with this sulfur halides is you can also prepare the spiro compounds in organic synthesis. So the treatment of halide called diphenyl oxo sulfonium cyclopropylide. The treatment of this diphenyl oxo sulfonium cyclopropylide with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound generally results the formation of a spiro derivative. So this is also one kind of application with this sulfur halides. Let us discuss about the mechanism involved in this. As we know, the initial step in this reaction is the nucleophilic addition. So the carbon, that means carbenium in halide, generally acts as nucleophile. It attacks the soft electrophile, that means it prefers one for addition. Which gives you a deuterion intermediate followed by the intramolecular nucleophilic addition onto this electrophile, which bears a good leaving group here. The loss of diphenyl sulfoxide gives you the spiro derivative. So this is the one kind of application with the sulfur halide with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, which produces spiro derivatives. So the same reagent, that is diphenyl oxo sulfonium cyclopropylide with the just carbonyl compound. So there is no alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, which results the formation of oxospirane derivative. So let us consider the mechanism here. As we know, the initial step is the nucleophilic attack. The nucleophilic attack onto this electrophile, which results the deuterion intermediate followed by the intramolecular nucleophilic attack onto this electrophilic carbon, which results oxo spiro derivative. So this oxo spiro derivative, oxo spirane, is unstable, so that this will open the ring, and gives cyclobutanone. So the reaction of this diphenyl sulfoxonium cyclopropylide with the just carbonyl compound, which results the oxospirane, which is unstable, so that the ring open up gives you the cyclobutanol derivative. So this is one kind of application with the sulfur halides. Let us consider other application where a simple sulfonium halide, that is dimethyl sulfonium cyclopropylide, which is also unstable reactive. When you treat this with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, as we know, just the sulfonium halide, okay, which is unstable or reactive, generally it prefers the 1-2 addition. Okay, so because of this 1-2 addition of this sulfonium halide with this alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, generally results the oxospirane derivative. For example, consider the mechanism here, the nucleophilic attack onto this electrophilic carbon, which results a deuterion followed by this oxy, that means oxygen anion, which attacks onto this electrophile, which bears the good leaving group dimethyl sulfide. So the loss of a good leaving group dimethyl sulfide, which results the oxospirane derivative. As we know, this oxospirane derivative unstable what happens the ring open up takes place here, so which results a cyclobutanone derivative. So there are three applications we have discussed so far, that is diphenyl sulfoxonium cyclopropylide, when you treat with the alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, which gives you a spiro derivative, whereas the same diphenyl sulfoxonium halide cyclopropylide, when you treat with the just carbonyl compound, which results the oxospirane derivative, which is unstable, the ring opens, gives you cyclobutanone derivative. Whereas if you take just sulfonium halide, sulfonium cyclopropylide, when you treat with this alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, it prefers the 1-2 addition, so that it gives you oxospirane derivative, which is unstable, and the ring opens takes place, which gives you a cyclobutanone derivative. So how to prepare this sulfonium cyclopropylide? So to prepare this cyclopropylide derivative, that is dimethyl sulfonium cyclopropylide derivative, so you need to have a dihalo compound, that is start with the chloroiodo 1,2,3 cyclopropane derivative with the dimethyl sulfide. So the electrons present on this sulfur makes this sulfur access nucleophile, attack at this electrophilic carbon, so that the loss of iodine gives you a sulfonium salt or sulfonium ion. So when you treat this sulfonium ion with the base, it abstracts the proton and form an halide. Now this carbanion acts as nucleophile, that means it acts as intramolecular nucleophile, so it attacks onto this electrophilic center, which bears a chloride nucleophile, that means leaving group, chloride leaving group, so which gives you a cyclopropane derivative. This cyclopropane, that means this is also a sulfonium salt, so So now if you treat with this sulfonium salt with the base which abstract the proton again, and gives our required halide, that is dimethyl sulfonium cyclopropylide. So with this cyclopropylide you can prepare oxo spirene derivatives by treating with alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, so that which are unstable, that oxo spirene derivatives are unstable, and you will get a cyclobutanone derivatives from the oxo spirene derivatives. So the sulfur halides, generally they have different kind of applications in organic synthesis. So these are the applications so far we discussed, that means the preparation of epoxides, preparation of azuridines, preparation of cyclopropane derivatives, preparation of oxospirane derivatives from sulfur halides. So there are different kind of applications we have with the sulfur halides. That means sulfur halides can also undergo rearrangements, or there are some different kind of name reactions we have with the sulfur halides, which will be discussed in the next video. Thank you.